the representative of the Government of India, P. Pillai, on 1 January 1948 sent a letter to the President of the United Nations Security Council transmitting a telegraphic communication from the Government of India dated December 31, 1947, lodging a complaint with the United Nations Security Council under Article 35 of the United Nations Charter, was a recognition of the sovereign position of the state of Jammu Kashmir to the world body upon the request of Indian Dominion. The instrument of accession, dated 26 October 1947, and the reply by the then Governor General of India, Lord Mountbatten, on 27 October 1947 was and is a legal basis of the relations between India and the state of Jammu and Kashmir, that is in the political and legal terms, a treaty-based relations. It is also recognized both by India and the United Nations that the subject treaty is under special circumstances and subject to be the approval of the people of that state of Jammu and Kashmir.
It is also recognized by both the India and the United Nations that the subject treaty was under special circumstances and subject to be approval of the people of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Furthermore, under the terms of the subject treaty, the Government of India is under treaty obligations to use all means to vacate the territory of the state from foreign forces, so to bring peace, enabling people of the United State of Jammu Kashmir to decide their future once for all democratically.
The complaint by the Government of India to the United Nations and the recognition of the Provisional Treaty of Accession put the state of Jammu Kashmir at par with the Indian Union. This means the Union government cannot amend or change without the approval of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. The Parliament of India cannot decide on behalf of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. All the decisions by the Indian Parliament for Jammu and Kashmir are illegal, forced occupation and colonial. The question that the treaty had been ratified by Constituent Assembly of Jammu Kashmir was brought up to the attention of the United Nations during 1957. And rejected because of the same legal reason. Moreover, the International Commission of Jurists, ICJ, a non-governmental body having consultative status with the United Nations, had expressed the same legal opinion in their report published during 1994, that the people of Jammu Kashmir have yet to exercise their right to self-determination.